All right, welcome everyone. In today's testing tutorial, I'm going to show you how to write Nightwatch JS automated tests in TypeScript. Programming Nightwatch tests in TypeScript is a newer ability that I feel at this time has been baked out enough to use when writing my tests. Using TypeScript has many advantages over JavaScript, such as intellisense when writing your tests and the ability to catch many mistakes as you're writing your tests instead of when you're running them. I recently figured out all the steps needed, so in today's video, I'm going to show you how to convert an existing Nightwatch test suite originally written in JavaScript into TypeScript. All right, so if you want to follow along, I'm going to put my source code here on github.com/reallymellow under Nightwatch tutorials. So I'm going to basically convert what I have currently under POM example and put that under POM TypeScript example for the finished product. So you can just do a gh repo clone of reallymellow Nightwatch tutorials to go ahead and get that on your system and follow along as I continue here. All right, so since the code is already on my system, I'm going to open up the POM example folder and show you what we already have in there. So it's a simple Nightwatch JavaScript project with a Google test.js file with a simple test, uses the page object model, and instantiates a Google page up here. And then it uses that Google page object to go ahead and navigate and assert the title and do some searching, and then verifies that Nightwatch appears on the search results. So using this example suite will be a good example of what you'll need to do to convert an existing JavaScript test suite that you have in Nightwatch over to TypeScript. So let's get started by taking the tests and page objects folder and moving those into this POM TypeScript example folder. And you can put that wherever you want on your system, but that's where I'm going to go for today. So when you're working in TypeScript, the convention usually is that you put your source files in a folder called source. So I'm going to dump these under source. All right, so now we have our page object and our test under the source folder. So now we can go ahead and set up the rest of the test project. So now to create our package.json file, since we don't have one yet, I'm going to run npm init-y to use the default configuration. And so now if we open that up, we should have a package.json file. And now we need to fill that with our dependencies that we're going to need for this. So now would be a good time to install Nightwatch globally on your computer. So to do that, we're going to type in npm install nightwatch-g for global. So now let's bring in the rest of our packages and save those into our package.json. So we're going to type in npm install nightwatch TypeScript. We're going to bring in @types nightwatch. And these are going to be all the Nightwatch TypeScript types from the DefinitelyTyped library. And lastly, let's install Gecko driver and Chrome driver. And we're going to save those as developer dependencies or development dependencies. All right, so now that we have our dev dependencies, we can create a Nightwatch configuration file. So to do so, I'm just going to type Nightwatch here with that one existing, so that should error out, and create a default configuration file for me. So if I open that up, we have our source folders and page objects path. For source folders, we're going to specify a new directory that doesn't exist yet called dist. And inside there, we're going to look under source, and inside there, we're going to look under tests. So when we compile transpile our TypeScript, it's going to go ahead and move everything into a folder called dist and mirror our existing folder structure here. So it's going to be under source tests, and that's where we're going to look for our tests. Similarly, we're going to do the same for our page objects. So we'll change that to page objects under dist source, spelled correctly. So we'll save that. And since I like using Chrome on this system, I'm going to scroll down to the default section under desired capabilities. I'm going to change the browser name from Firefox to Chrome. And if you haven't installed TypeScript globally, let's do that as well. So let's type in npm install TypeScript-g. And now that TypeScript is installed, I can run tsc-init to create our tsconfig.json file. And here it is over here. So in here, let's scroll down to outdir. And we're going to uncomment that. And we're going to change that from .slash to dist so that it moves all of our transpiled source code into the dist folder. And then the next option we're going to do is allow JS. So go down, find that. On mine, it's on line 40. And we're going to leave that as true. And as the name implies, this will allow you to work with JavaScript files within the same project as your TypeScript files, which is great because if you have a very large project like I do, you don't need to do a big bang approach to actually convert everything at once. You can have your JavaScript and TypeScript Nightwatch tests living side by side along with your page objects so that you can just kind of convert at your own leisurely pace. All right, so now we have all of our packages installed and our configuration set. So now we can go ahead and start working in our code. So let's start off by converting the googlepage.js file. So the first thing we'll do is rename the file extension from js to .ts to let the IDE know what we're doing. And it should start to give us some errors. So the first thing we'll need to do is add an import statement at the top to bring in the types we're going to use. So that's simply saying import. We're going to take the page object model type and enhanced page object model type from the Nightwatch definitely typed directory. And that came in from that at types Nightwatch import that we did earlier. So all these types come out of here. All right, so now that we have our types, we can use them. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is get rid of this module exports pattern, and I'm going to name this as a constant of Google page, and I'm going to give it the type page object model. And the page object model now has all these different types on it. So if I try and change something like URL to something that does not exist, it's going to complain about it and gives you a nice little suggestion. Did you mean to write URL? Well, yes, I did. So the page object model types actually even extend into the various elements. So if I'm defining elements in here, and I'm not quite sure all the different options that are available to me. Again, if I type in something wrong, like selector, then it tells me that that does not exist, so I can fix that. But it also reveals to me the other properties on here. So if I want to specify things like the locate strategy, I can do so. And it lets me know exactly what locate strategies are valid as well. So I can say this is a CSS selector if I want, which keeps me from making silly mistakes. So if I said CSS selectors, that's gonna error out as well. And that's pretty awesome, especially if you're getting started with Nightwatch and you're not sure of all the syntax. So let's just save that up. And now you'll notice that we have some squiggly errors here. That's because it's expecting a type for the this object that gets passed in, and that is gonna be an enhanced page object. And that should resolve all of the problems in here. So the last thing we need to do is now export this as an interface. So to do so, we're going to go down to the bottom and we're going to say export default Google page. And now we're going to export the interface. So we're going to say export interface Google page extends enhanced page object. And the enhanced page object type takes up to three different inputs, the first one being your commands, the second one being your elements, and if you have any sections, that is a third optional one. So this one doesn't use any sections, so we're going to start off by just saying type of commands, or Google commands. And then the next one, we're going to say type of Google page.elements, and close it out with the double curlies. And that's all you need to do to create a Nightwatch JS page object using TypeScript. So now that we've converted our page object to TypeScript, let's do the same for our test. So similarly, we're going to change the file extension first. So let's type that as .ts. So now in googletest.ts, we start to get our squigglies letting us know that TypeScript isn't happy. So let's make it happy. So in our test, we're going to use Nightwatch tests and Nightwatch browser. So let's import those at the top. And let's get rid of this module exports, and we'll call that const Google test. We'll give that a type of Nightwatch tests. And now that we've named Google test, we can export it down here at the bottom. So let's do that before we forget. Export default Google test and save that. So I'm going to change the way I do this a little bit. So I'm going to take off the function call and use arrows. And now we just need to fix this. So TypeScript doesn't like it when you leave things untyped. So that right now browser has the anytype, so it's giving you a warning. So we're gonna go ahead and type that as a Nightwatch browser. So now that we put a type on browser, we have all this nice IntelliSense here that's exposing the Nightwatch API. So now you can see that we have keys and assert, base URL and all this stuff that you might not be totally familiar with unless you've read the Nightwatch documentation very thoroughly like I have. So let's stop being silly for a moment and back that out. Let's change the let to a const on Google, and let's type the Google page object to Google page. And so that adds the import statement here at the top, import Google page from page objects Google page. So now that we added the Google page object model type to the Google constant, similar to when we added that to the browser object, we'll have all the IntelliSense available to us so we know if we're making any mistakes and what's actually available to us. So we know that the click search options here now. And if it took any kind of inputs here, it would let us know, but it lets us know that the signature here is just an empty method. So we know we can just call it just like that. And if we, you know, made a mistake, it would let us know that it doesn't accept that. All right, expect zero arguments, but we put one in there. So let's get rid of that. Since this was a valid test before, it should remain a valid test after, right? So that we don't have any squiggles or underlines here, and click search is available, like it always was. But again, if I typed a mistake here, it would let me know about it. So let's save that up and just quickly recap. You just need to bring in your imports at the top so that you have access to your types. To add types to any variable, you just go ahead and use this colon and then the type name, and it adds it in. Otherwise, it's going to default to the any type, which is wide open, just like JavaScript is. And then once you have that all wired up, you should get rid of any errors that you might be seeing or warnings from the TypeScript compiler. And lastly, when you switch over from module exports, you need to make sure that you actually export const Google test here down at the bottom. So export default Google test. All right, so at this point, we should have a working Nightwatch test suite written in TypeScript, but there's some final things we need to do here to get it all running. Let's go ahead and open our package.json file. You'll notice that by default, it just has a not specified for the test command. So what we're gonna do is specify one. And TypeScript adds a little bit of complexity in that you need to transpile your tests, meaning that TypeScript needs to transform your TypeScript files into JavaScript. And when it does that, since we specified it in that configuration at the top of the tutorial, it's gonna dump those into the dist source folder. So the most pain-free option I found to do that is to specify everything that you need to do as like a chained test command here. So the first thing we do is type in TSC, which is the TypeScript compiler, then do a double ampersand sign, and then run Nightwatch. But basically, this is the only prefix you need to worry about that is going to be different than anything else that you were doing. So if you're adding extra flags here to Nightwatch to run certain environments or certain reporters or whatever, you just add that here and it will work as normal. You can also break these out and do this separately if you're running it manually on the command line, but this makes it a little bit easier. So enough talking, let's do npm test. All right, we have a success. Beautiful. At the top here, you can see once we typed in npm test, it ran TSC and Nightwatch. Here's our test output down below. You saw the browser pop up. And if you look, we have a surprise here under TypeScript example. We have our dist folder that got created with source, page objects, and our page object and Google test. You'll notice that they're back to JS extensions because they were transpiled by the TSC command. And if we open it up, you can see what that turns into in JavaScript. And again, what makes this all possible are the type declarations that we brought in when we did npm install at types Nightwatch. And if you're curious, this is where all this comes from under definitely typed in the types Nightwatch folder. You can go ahead and look here through index.d.ts to find out everything that's available to you as far as a type's concerned. The maintainers are doing a really good job building this out for Nightwatch 2.0, but if there's anything that's missing, you can go ahead and add an issue or submit a pull request, and they're very good about adding it in. All right, so that's how you convert your existing Nightwatch tests and page objects into TypeScript. Check the video description down below for a link to the accompanying source code on GitHub, and while there, please click on the like button if you enjoyed the video and consider subscribing for more testing tutorials. Thanks for watching.